This morning, new details are emerging about a meeting involving a former Trump campaign advisor and an undercover investigator for the FBI. The New York Times reporting that just 2 months before the 2016 presidential election, George Papadopoulos met with a woman who was posing as a university research assistant, but unknown to him at the time, she was actually working for the FBI. And during the meeting, the woman asked Papadopoulos whether the Trump campaign had been working with Russia. Joining us now is Mark Mazzetti, Washington investigative correspondent for the New York Times. He co-authored that report, and Josh Campbell, he's a former FBI supervisory special agent. Mark, begin with you. It's your reporting here. So we already knew that Papadopoulos had met a Cambridge professor who turned into a confidential informant, in effect. We did not know that the FBI had someone there. Tell us what you know.
Right. So in September of 2016, this guy, Stefan Helper, reaches out to Papadopoulos. He's a Cambridge University professor. He's also worked as a confidential informant for some time with the FBI. He tells Papadopoulos he wants to meet him in London and that he wants him to author a study about energy issues in the Mediterranean. When Papadopoulos arrives, he first meets a woman he met he knew as Azra Turk. We're reporting that this woman, we don't know her real name, was actually sent by the FBI to gather information and kind of oversee the whole process with Helper, someone who's more directly involved with the U.S. government and potentially to gather evidence, even to testify in court if need be. So it was someone to sort of control the operation and sort of shows the extent, the alarm inside the FBI at this period of time.
Josh Campbell, you say this is evidence the FBI was doing its job. Tell us why you believe that.
Well, and I think it's important to distinguish. I'm reacting to this reporting, not based on anything I learned when I was in government. It's important to point that
Understood.
Out. But if you look at what this reporting states, I mean, this is standard operating procedure for any FBI investigation. Undercover operations, the use of informants, these are investigative tools that help the FBI go places that they cannot go themselves. An FBI agent trying to get to the bottom of a string of bank robberies, for example, or a terrorist group, and yes, even a campaign for president that has, these suspicious ties to a foreign adversary, an FBI agent can't just announce themselves and start asking questions. So you're going to use these tools that help, again, the FBI go where it can't go on its
right.
own. It's important to point out, and I've heard the president, this morning he's already tweeting about it, but he's calling this spying, and his allies will say this is abuse. These types of operations are highly scrutinized inside the Justice Department, and there's oversight. So, this will be, we're going to see politics come out of this, but it's important to keep that in mind. These are tools the FBI uses every single day.
Well, listening to Barr's testimony earlier this week, he said very openly that he has ordered his own investigation as to how this original counterintelligence investigation began during the 2016 campaign. I want to play those comments here and then ask your view on how far this will go. Have a listen.
The scope of the OIG, do you understand or do you know what the scope of that report will be?
Well, I don't want to be too specific. I talked to Mike Horowitz a few weeks ago about it, and it's focused on the FISA, the basis for the FISA and the handling of the FISA applications. But by necessity, it looks back a little bit earlier than that.
OIG is referring to the Office of the Inspector General, but Barr also made clear in the testimony he has his own investigation he's opening. Mark, you've been covering this a long time. How significant could this investigation be? Could it lead to the possibility of criminal referrals for oversteps during the start of this investigation?
Yeah, I mean, anything would certainly be possible. I mean, we know that as the Inspector General is digging into this issue, we expect that he's going to have some kind of report in the next couple of months. And as the Attorney General said, they're very focused on this issue of the FISA, the predicate for the FISA for another advisor, Carter Page, but they're looking at the predicate for the whole operation, the whole counterintelligence investigation. The Papadopoulos story is certainly interesting because at that point, recall, it was the reason, Papadopoulos was the primary reason they opened it in the beginning because he talked to an Australian diplomat about the Russians. And so his role is quite interesting in terms of the backstory and what the FBI wanted to know. But as we now know, he didn't have the goods on some real direct link with the Russians.
Josh, there are legitimate questions here, are there not, as to what is the standard that the FBI or other U.S. law enforcement can deploy resources like that to look at someone, an American citizen, mind you, participating in a presidential campaign? I mean, what is the standard that would allow that decision to be made?
Well, as I mentioned, something like this would have high-level oversight, high-level scrutiny. One thing I think it's important to point out is that, you know, I watched the Barr hearing, as we all did, and it's interesting that the framing here from the president's allies seemed to be that an investigation into the FBI is somehow punitive or pejorative. I think, in my own judgment, that that's actually a good thing. We need to get to the bottom of exactly what happened, because I think that will help the American people determine what's politics and what's reality, and having that independent inspector general do that work is important. I've talked to people inside the FBI who think that this will vindicate them. You know, finally, here, lay out the facts. So let us show you what we did when faced with this situation. So this framing that this is somehow negative, I think, is wrong. The problem that I think that I have and that we all need to be focused on is that even though the inspector general is independent, if past is prologue, we can expect the politics to continue. All you have to do is look at the inspector general's review of the FBI's involvement with the Hillary Clinton case. They came out and said that there was misbehavior, but it didn't impact in the investigation. Yet we continue to hear to this day the president beating that drum that there was this corrupt cabal that was trying to help Hillary Clinton and take down him. So we're going to get the facts. We're going to know what happened. But again, I'm under no illusions that the president and his allies will accept a conclusion that says that the FBI, you know, did something right. I think they're going to continue on all the way through 2020 trying to paint the president as a victim.
Okay. We'll see what the results of the investigation are. Mark Mazzetti, Josh Campbell, thanks very much.